Oh no.
This could save everything.
The fact that thousands of people are going to watch this is just painful.
Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. So if you need a website, go to squarespace.com/Heaton. This is the worst day I have ever had with my camera. As a landscape photographer, it's not uncommon to have to deal with disappointment and frustration when in the field, but most of the time we can place the blame on external factors such as the weather. But today, I can only blame myself as I make error after error and face incredible amounts of frustration as I witness the best light I have ever seen in my life, yet struggle to take an image. And the worst part is, I'm shooting everything on film, so my doubts are amplified 10 times as I can't check the images to see how costly my mistakes were. Usually, I like to show the images throughout the video, but today, I want you to feel the same amount of uncertainty as I did. So all of the images captured in today's video will be shown at the end.
Well, hello everybody and welcome to another video. Today, I'm going to be doing a big hike up into the clouds, and I'm only going to be shooting panoramics with a fixed focal length. Wait till you see the camera I've got. Unbelievable. If you enjoy the content of this video, the best thing you can do to support the channel by far is just hit the like button. That's it. So if you enjoy it, like it. If not, well, hit the thumbs down button, I suppose. All right, onwards. Of course, there are other ways to support the channel. If you're not aware, I do have a hardback book available, Landscape Photography on Location. And I've also got my 2021 calendar, which I am very proud of. And actually, I think it's my best calendar to date because I guess it kind of reflects the way my photography has changed over the past year or two. So if you're interested in any of that, maybe as a Christmas present, you can find it in the description below. Tell you what though, oh, this is such a nice day. So my plan is to climb a mountain called Pillar. It's in the Lake District and it's very close, in fact it's opposite the highest mountain in England, which is Scarfell Pike. Now Pillar is a good old mountain. I'm not sure of the exact height. I think it's about 900, maybe 930, 950 meters, something like that. It's big, big old mountain. And the views from the top of that mountain are unbelievable. They are stunning, they really are. So the reason I've chosen this mountain to climb today is because this time last week, me and my friend did a hike called the Mosedale Horseshoe, which is a 10-mile route that takes in several high peaks, including Pillar. And I took my camera with me on that hike. I took my X-T4 with a 55 to 200 millimeter lens. And what a day. What a day. The light was spectacular. The conditions were phenomenal. It was cloudy, misty, patchy sunlight, full of mood, full of atmosphere. And I have to say, it was quite liberating not having a tripod and not having a video camera. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to show a couple of those images from the trip. And you'll see the reason why I'm coming back. But on that trip, I was restricted to a medium to long lens. Whereas today, I'm restricted to a mega wide pano, which is gonna be interesting. So the complete opposite of what I did last week is what I'm doing today. Anyway, I'll play the images now and you'll get an idea why I'm back here. So this is my new camera, my new old camera, and it's called a Fuji GX617, and it's essentially, well, it's a film camera that shoots exclusively panoramas, 6x17 format. And if you watch this channel, you'll know that I love a bit of panoramic photography. I absolutely adore it. And one of the best purchases I've made in the past year was my Hasselblad 501cm, which shoots square. And I find shooting on film an absolute joy and a pleasure. And then when I saw that you could get these big panoramic cameras that have the same form factor and the same ergonomics, kind of, as just a regular camera, like an SLR or something like that, I was too tempted. It was too tempting, so I had to get one. I only have one lens, and this is a 90mm lens, which, when put on this camera, is actually super wide, like really wide angle. Now, I don't know the exact conversion when it comes to full frame. However, I expect it's somewhere along the lines of shooting with, let's say, a 20mm lens and then cropping it to a panorama. Now, because I'm shooting with such a wide lens and it's such a wide piece of film, you get very heavy vignetting. So I've got this filter. I don't know if it comes across. Let me just see if we can dial you down and show you. Yeah, you can see there, this is called a center filter. And it's like an ND filter where it's dark in the middle. So it's like the opposite of a vignette. So I have to screw this onto the camera every time I take an image to balance out what would be a very heavy vignette. Now let me talk you through my composition. So the beauty of this camera, especially with the 90mm mega wide lens and the mega wide aspect ratio of the panel, the beauty of it is, it's very easy, very simple. You know, it's very much point and shoot, which is great, you know. So that's what we're doing here. We're at the top of the Mosedale Valley, and we're looking down over this fantastic looking valley with two peaks either side. Now, unfortunately, unlike my hike up here last week, we don't have any light. But it does look like we've got a bit of mood and atmosphere, which is why I framed up this shot. And it also looks like rain is on the way. It just seems to be getting a bit murky and a bit misty, and the wind's picking up, which usually is a signal for rain. So I'm gonna crack on, get this shot on Kodak Ektar 100, and see what else we can find from this beautiful hike. So that's the shutter cocked. F32, 1/8 of a second, Ektar 100. As simple as that. So I've just come up the hill from where I took that photograph, and it's bizarre. As you come up the hill, the wind stops. So it must be hitting the brow of the hill there and going over my head. It's much calmer here. So I'm just stopping to have a break. It's a heck of a hike up here. So I'm gonna have a cup of tea and I'll have some food. I was just thinking about that image. I can't help but think I took it in a bit of a rush. I kind of felt like the rain was coming towards me. It turns out it hasn't started to rain yet, but it felt as if the rain was coming. And I know that it is forecast for showers to be coming in off the sea, which is just a couple of miles that way. So yeah, I'm not sure about the image. It's a shame there's no light. You know, it's very, very dark that way. Let me just show you the sky over there. It's very, very dull and socked in. So man, that composition that we just shot there, and if we had some lovely patchwork of light on those fells just like last week, it would have been phenomenal. But unfortunately, it looks like it's not going to be the case today. as always with film, I haven't got a clue if that has turned out. So I'll be quite embarrassed whilst editing this video if the images are terrible. But, you know, it's part of the fun. It really is. It really is. But hey, day out in the fells, nobody around, spectacular views, hot tea, and some nice food. It really is a great way to spend the day. So one thing I never mentioned about that camera is that it only takes 4 images per roll of film, whereas the Hasselblad, for example, takes 12. So I've taken 2, and I'm thinking wisely about how to use the last 2 frames. So that's where I'm going. As you can see, completely socked in. So, you know, it's hard to get the motivation to go when you know you're going to go into zero visibility. And I know the views from there are amazing, but as you can see all around me, it is equally socked in. So I've been walking around here on this sort of plateau, taking in the conditions. You know, the temperature's really dropped and the cloud base has also dropped. I'm losing all of the peaks that I could previously see, but I have found the composition. But I don't know if you can notice, the wind has picked up and I feel very rushed with this composition. I really do. So you have to forgive me. The filming isn't great, but I'm gonna get on with this because the wind's picked up, the cloud base is dropping and dropping and dropping, and it really does feel like a change is in the air. I know I said this before that I felt like the rain was coming, but I feel like it really could be coming now. So I grabbed the shot. Yeah, may or may not work, but it caught my eye. So I've just realized an error that I made on the first image that I took. Oh man, it was 2 stops underexposed because I didn't account for the center filter that I put on. 2 stops underexposed. Can it be rescued with a good scan? Probably not. Yeah. Damn it. So I'm at f38, 1 second, and that should be a correct exposure. I sometimes question why I put this sort of stuff on my channel. So that was f38. At 1 second. And whilst I think the composition is nice, I still don't feel that it's great. And the weather is really moving in now. The last time I shot black and white film was when I was 16 years old at Blackpool and the Fylde College, which is where I went to study media production and photography. And a good friend of mine, James Bell, you might know him if you watch him, Capture Lakeland is his handle. He very kindly sent me a roll of Ilford Delta 400, He also sent me a list of 12 challenges because it was intended to be used in my Hasselblad, which has 12 frames. But I'm really sorry, James. I'm going to have to forfeit your challenges because right now I have a composition that I think will work rather well with black and white film. Of course, the problem is conditions are so changeable that I may very well have loaded this film and then my shot has disappeared. Oh, who knows? So the shot is very dependent on the right mood and atmosphere. Without the right type of mist and cloud rolling through, the image is neither here nor there. So timing is everything. There's essentially a ridge line running from left to right, and then it goes up Kirkfell, which is this huge mountain. I'm photographing that ridge line. There's lots of crags and rocks on it, and the mist is rolling between the crags and rocks and coming in off Kirkfell, and it looks very moody, very cool. But what I'm waiting for is that really low cloud to hit the fell and swoop up, because at the minute it's an image of two halves. The top half is just completely kind of flat and white, and the bottom half is it's kind of dark and no mood. The problem, of course, is every time the mist rolls in, it changes the exposure settings. So, yeah, it's just hard, man. I'm sure we've got an image here. I'm sure of it. So I'm basically going for 1 second F32, focus to infinity. And with this camera, you don't focus through the viewfinder, you just purely focus using the depth of field scale on the lens. And that tells you more or less what's going to be in focus depending on where you place the markers. So I'm F32, so if I place infinity marker at F32, the lens tells me what's going to be sharp. So in this instance, it tells me that everything from 2.5 feet to infinity will be acceptably sharp. So pretty cool. Okay, took a shot. Not convinced it was the right shot, but you know, yeah, got 3 more goes at this. God, it's so changeable. So that was F32 at 1 second. All right, I think we'll go again. Oh, I just took a double exposure. Oh my God. All right, there we go. That is a whole roll of film burned on this one composition. Although one of those was a double exposure, so yeah, that's just fun, isn't it? Every time I make a mistake, it's very much a learning process, and hopefully I won't make the same mistake again. That's my thinking. So, yeah. Oh no. So I didn't put my center ND filter on. Oh my God. How could I have forgotten that step? I've never forgotten that step. And I don't mind the vignette, it could actually add to the image, but the problem is I will have overexposed these photographs by two stops. Maybe the film can handle it. I really don't know. But my first two images were underexposed by two stops, and my last images were overexposed by two stops. I think I've just about made every single mistake. Incorrect exposure by not accounting for the filter. Double exposure because I pressed the trigger again. And then incorrect exposure by accounting for a filter that wasn't on. I am not an advocate for film photography right now. But I do believe that every mistake is a lesson learned. And I'm sure that this will never, ever happen again. Ah! Oh, it's gonna be so embarrassing sending this film off to the lab. So the rain has now finally started. I'm gonna be completely honest with you. Right now I'm just feeling like this whole video, this whole hike, this whole photo shoot has been a complete disaster. And whilst the hike has been nice, and it's always nice to get out, let's not try and lose sight of that, but I kind of felt like I was constantly fighting the conditions because they were so changeable. And I made so many mistakes. Pretty much every mistake you can make, I've made today. And if any images did come out, it's pure luck. That's all, pure luck. So right now I'm not feeling good. I love shooting film, and I do think that when you get it right, it's nothing can beat it. It's a beautiful thing. But right now I'm feeling like I'm feeling about this big. And, you know, if I upload this video to YouTube, I guess I'll just have to try and, you know, pull some kind of lesson out of it. You have good days and bad days, let's put it that way. Good days and bad days, and today, unfortunately, is a bad day. The fact that thousands of people are going to watch this is just painful, but, you know, I always say, don't judge the images in my video. They are not my portfolio. My portfolio is on my website. Go there. My book is my portfolio. My calendar is my portfolio. My gosh, it's getting dark. That's the rain coming. This is just a stitch in life's rich tapestry. And I hope that from today, I will be a better film photographer in the future. So signing off, guys, signing off. I'm gonna go home and reflect and dwell in my misery. Cheers, guys. Thanks for watching. My God. Get it out.
Oh, this could save everything. All right, be calm, be calm, be calm. What's gonna work? What's gonna work? Right, got a load of film. Yes, don't make any mistakes. Don't make any mistakes.
Better. Oh, there's no way this isn't gonna work.
Oh, wow. Oh my God. Oh, I talk about good luck and bad luck all at the same time. Okay. Right, what do I actually want to shoot here? What do I actually want to shoot? I left the boot of my car open. And I'm miles from my car. Okay, this. Kind of cool. Let's have a look. Oh god, I hate this. Yep, that doesn't work. So it appears my video did not end when I thought it was going to end. So it's quite funny, I was walking back down, I was miserable, it was raining, I was wet, it was grey. It was just awful. And I remember fantasizing about there being an open patch of sky to the west that would let the last of the light through. And I thought, nah, it's never going to happen. And as I'm walking and walking and getting closer to my car, I saw there, in fact, was a gap, and I couldn't believe it. Now, I don't know this area, so I didn't know where to go, but I knew I just needed to drive down the lake. So, jumped in my car, drove down, and I was chasing the light, because I could see it developing, and then the light just exploded. It was the most phenomenal light I've ever seen. And that's at the point where I was in the boot of my car, desperately trying to gather my things. But I was too late. I was 10 minutes too late. I needed to have more time to find a composition or something. So I loaded some Provia into the back of my camera, Provia 100, very quickly. In fact, it's the quickest I've ever managed to load film, which is pretty good. Ran down to the lake. And unfortunately, whilst the colour and light was nice, I definitely missed the best of the light. It was incredible, vibrant red with this rainbow. It was unreal. But there was no way to compose it. It was just, man, it's almost just like I was being tormented. And then I swung my camera around to the west, facing the setting sun. And there was beautiful colour, lovely clouds, and a half decent image, which is the one I've just captured. But the truth is, honestly, I just pointed my camera towards the light. I don't think the composition was very good. I don't know, but when you see moments like that, you have to try and capture them. I will be amazed if I get one of those images, you know, if one of those comes out. And if it does, and it is in fact a nice image, well, that could save the day. Because all I've done is make mistakes today. And at the end, at the final hour, I don't think I made any mistakes. I learned from my mistakes. But I was just in the wrong place. We'll see. You know, I just wish I had that 10 more minutes. But wow, that was phenomenal. I don't think I got any of it really on film. I don't know. So, if in fact I did get an image, you know, I'll put it on screen at the end of this video. And but right now I've gone from feeling miserable and sorry for myself to feeling excited, adrenaline filled, and feeling like I might have actually got a photograph. So, there we go. It's never over until it's over. Now, I'm definitely going to call it a day. Cheers, guys. And until next time, bye for now.
So after a day fraught with errors and frustrations, let's have a look at the images. The first photo of the Mosedale Valley, to my surprise, turned out okay.
And I'll take a second shot, which will be a stop brighter, at a quarter of a second.
Because of that second brighter exposure, the film handled the scene just fine, so it definitely pays to bracket. second image is exactly what I thought it would be. Neither here nor there. I think it's okay, but I don't love the composition and the sky is completely blown out. For the third image, even though I forgot to add my two-stop center ND filter, to my surprise, also turned out okay. And actually, the vignette helped with the mood and atmosphere of the day. I don't love the image, but it's certainly better than I had hoped. Finally, after a frantic search for a composition, I knew in my heart of hearts that this image was not going to be anything special. I simply didn't have time to find a good composition. I exposed the scene well and everything is sharp, but I have to live with the fact that I know the image could have been so much better if only I had a few more minutes on location. So, as always guys, I love to read your comments and hear your thoughts on the images from today's video. If you've enjoyed it, give the video a like. And before I leave, I'll just say a big thank you to Squarespace for sponsoring today's video. If you don't know who Squarespace are, they're an all-in-one website building platform where you can log on and build a very professional looking website with a very easy, intuitive drag and drop system. So if you are afraid of coding, HTML, PHP, and all that technical stuff, definitely give those a go if you need a website for your photography. So if that's what you want to do, go to squarespace.com/Heaton and give it a free try. And if you like free trial, use the offer code Heaton for 10% off your first purchase. And with that, I'm going to leave. So until next time, thanks for watching. And bye for now.